डेवलपमेंट लाइफ साइकिल फॉर मेडिकल डिवाइस। फर्स्टली आई वुड लाइक टू डिस्कस ऑन व्हाई देयर इज अ स्पेसिफिक रिक्वायरमेंट फॉर अ लाइफ साइकिल प्रोसेस फॉर मेडिकल डिवाइस। एज आई सेड, मेडिकल डिवाइस सॉफ्टवेयर इज प्लेइंग अ ह्यूज रोल इन कंट्रोलिंग द मेडिकल डिवाइस विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू सेफ्टी एंड परफॉर्मेंस, विच इज डायरेक्टली गोइंग टू impact the patient who is getting the care from the care provider. So software is an integral part of the medical device technology nowadays. So safety and effective functioning of the medical device, it needs to be looked at from the process point of view, how it has been developed, how it has been controlled, and how it has been released, and how it the feedback mechanism works to maintain the software effectively. So there is one IEC international standard called IEC 62304, which defines the software lifecycle process for medical devices. What this standard talks about is it gives a framework for lifecycle process. It gives the requirements for what are all the activities and tasks to be performed while developing the software, and the interlinks with risk management, and it has requirements for classification, and it has got requirements for overall control of the process. We are going to discuss about all these things in the coming slides. Before going into those details, we will try to understand about few concepts of life cycle. What is a life cycle? Life cycle is going to help in breaking down the design of the product into phases to various design levels. And this ensures higher level parts of the design are fulfilled before it goes down to the next stage. So that means the output of one stage is becoming an input to the next stage. And this methodology will also allow verification of the output requirements of one stage to the next stage before the bug gets transmitted to a later stage. And this is one life cycle model what the standard is prescribing. It starts from the customer need. Customer could be an external customer or your own internal customers. Then the process starts. First thing is the system development activities, which includes risk management. Then there is a subset of risk management. And in the development activities, it is further broken down into various activities and tasks. Development planning, requirement analysis, architectural design, detailed design, coding testing, integration testing, system testing, release. After the release, there is a software problem resolution, that is your bug fix and the management. And of course, throughout the process, there is the configuration control, which is given as the configuration management there. And finally, once the software is released, it goes back to the customer with the customer needs satisfied. The common life cycle models which has been used across the industry, specifically for medical devices, are water flow model, incremental model, and evolutionary model. So there has been a lot of write-ups and all those stuffs which are available freely in the web on these models, and which is good, which is bad, it all depends on the situation in which the development is happening and based on the requirements. Irrespective of the model which it's been used for development, there are certain principles which is to be followed for medical devices. The standard clearly specifies that all the outputs should be maintained in a consistent state. That is, whenever in any process output is created or changed, all related outputs should be updated promptly to maintain their consistency with each other and to maintain all dependencies explicitly or implicitly. What this means? This means whatever the changes which you are doing throughout the process at whatever be the stage, you need to review it completely and then see the overall impact and then take actions wherever it is needed to update. So if it requires for you to go back to redefine your requirements from a testing phase, you need to do it. So that's what in nutshell it means. And it also talks about medical device software release. So before it is released, means before it is put in use, all the outputs should be consistent with each other and all dependencies between the process outputs explicitly or implicitly has to be verified and ascertained it is meeting the requirements before it is released. So we discussed about why a software development lifecycle model is required for a medical device and what are all the various practices which is there in the industry and why it is critical for a medical device.